In the last video, I said that the researchers who sequenced the Haemophilus influenzae genome assembled over 24,300 individual Sanger sequencing reads into 140 contigs, represented in a simplified way by the four contigs shown here. These contigs corresponded to sections of the organism's genome, but the researchers didn't know which contigs were next to each other in the genome, and they were missing the sequences in the gaps between the contigs. They could solve these problems by finding the sequence of each gap, which would allow them to join the contigs together into a complete genome. To start, they went back to their genomic DNA library and looked for the sequences at the ends of the contigs. Here I'm showing a plasmid from the library that contains an insert matching the sequence at the end of contig 3 from the previous image. In some cases, in that same insert, they found sequence that matched the end of another contig. That means that the sequence in the middle of this insert is the gap sequence missing between the two contigs. This type of gap is called a sequence gap. The missing sequence is in the genomic DNA library, it just wasn't sequenced in their original group of sequencing runs. This type of gap is easy to fill. You just design a sequencing primer matching one end of the contig, and use that to sequence the middle of the insert. You can then join the two contigs together into one larger contig. For the H. influenzae genome, 98 out of the 140 gaps were sequence gaps. That left them with 42 contigs, with 42 gaps in between them that were not present in the genomic DNA library. This type of gap is called a physical gap. Physical gaps could occur because the sequence in the gap is toxic to E. coli cells, or just because of bad luck when the genomic library was created. To fill in a physical gap, the researchers decided to use PCR. They designed PCR primers complementary to each end of the remaining contigs and pointing into the gaps. They then did PCR reactions using every possible combination of the PCR primers, using genomic DNA as the template. If the primers were close enough to generate a PCR product, then the researchers concluded that the corresponding contigs were next to each other in the genome. They sequenced the PCR product to fill in the physical gap. I'll go over that again using diagrams. Here we have four contigs in some different possible orders. The researchers designed PCR primers that would anneal to the ends of the contigs with the 3' end of each primer towards the physical gap. Suppose that this is the correct order of the contigs. If so, then certain combinations of primers will be properly positioned to make a PCR product. Other combinations will not be pointing in the proper directions, or they'll be too far away from each other for a PCR product to be possible. Primers that do work together will anneal to the genomic DNA sequence on either side of the physical gap and will make a PCR product that can be sequenced to fill the physical gap. This is how the remaining 42 contigs were joined together in the H. influenzae sequencing project to produce the intact genome. But just knowing the sequence of bases in the genome is not enough. We need to be able to interpret the information in the genome or annotate the genome. I'll talk about genome annotation in the next video.